Simpsons creator Matt Groening. He was living somewhere close or inside Springfield, Oregon, and eventually left his parents to go to Los Angeles. During his time in Los Angeles, he eventually made a series of comics called Life in Hell, and eventually became popular, and eventually got James Brooks' attention. Soon it would get Matt's doodling to pay off. Most networks at this time had at least one family show. They were more sweet and kind of bland. And those same networks were aimed at young children and everybody that was over their teenage years. However, Fox was brought to appeal to the opposite groups, teenagers. Matt's work on Life in Hell was perfect for the Fox program. However, Matt had a different idea. A show based on his childhood family, with his real parents having the same name as our show counterparts. The show was also made to be different from other family shows due to its realistic representation of real American families. And soon was the most popular segment in the Tracy Ullman show, and it was a no-brainer. And soon it was the show on Fox, and the show's attitude could be described by one of the characters, Bart Simpson. In season one, was more kind despite Bart being more mischievous. And season one was the basis of the show. Oh, the first half of the season's rougher animation gives it that season one charm. And with all of the show's qualities, it was a no-brainer to make the show a season two. In the 1990s, Bart Mania started, t-shirts, video games, becoming a role model. And at that point, he was the face of The Simpsons, and it shows. He was going to be the main star of the show before Bart Mania. The rest of the Golden Age introduced us to more characters, such as Superintendent Chalmers in Season 4. Bart Mania slowly died in 1995. Homer was becoming the main character at that time, and the stories were becoming more wacky because of it. They didn't hit as hard anymore, especially since Bart was no longer the main star. And in the 10th season, the show fell off in quality. It was never the same after Homer's enemy in season 8. Chapter 3, Everything After, Crappy Simpsons. Everything after is just mediocre, crappy, and is at this point copying other shows that once copied them. And at this point, we should just pray that there would be a renaissance, at least somewhat. And the most insane part, it's still going. It is not going down until the end of Earth. But there is a slight rise in quality and how good episodes are in general. And let's hope it would start leading into the renaissance. Conclusion. Simpsons, up until the end of the Golden Age, was great. It had good stories and episodes, and they were primarily the reason why the show got an 8 out of 10 on IMDb. The comedy in that era was great, superb even. But if you're going to watch The Simpsons, I would recommend you to watch seasons 1 through 8. It's probably the best you'll get. Anyways, this is Spike Bomb. Good day and good night, and I'm out.